got lettuces. It's got different types of lettuce, tomatoes, rocket, and there's a sweet cucumber around the edges, you can see. And it's got yak on as well, which is a very sweet root crop. That's it on top. And then decorating on the top is a kohlrabi. I just picked. Everything has been picked this afternoon, so it's all fresh.
Thank you, Jeff.
And over here, on this little pot, is a pickled, a type of kimchi with red mizuna and yakon. So it's pickled yakon. And it's got ginger and garlic and has got salt in it as well. So, there you go.
Thanks, James. Who's next?
All right, come on. This dish here is a butternut pumpkin with ginger and a little bit of tamari sauce. And also some mung bean and azuki bean sprouts. Mm. And we've also got another kimchi here, which is just a cabbage and carrot with a kind of a spicy ginger chili and salt as well.
Okay. Thanks, Brad.
Okay.
Who's next?
This is a sort of cake that I whipped up this afternoon from whatever I had in the cupboard. The bottom bit is, let's see what's in there, almonds, sesame seeds, dates, cinnamon, I think that's it. And the top is chia seeds and raisins and avocado and carob. And a bit of agave nectar and a bit of fresh mint.
Great. Thanks, Louise. Okay, who's next?
This is a salad that has basil, cucumber, chicken and liver, swede. I love swede. Basil, cucumber and swede, basically like sliced really thinly with a peeler, avocado, and a bit of what's the name of that? Miso mixed together.
Okay.
And I think that's pretty much it. And lettuce.
Okay. Thanks.
I don't know what it tastes like. And celery. Just keeps increasing. Yeah. That is it.
Did you make that in the car in the garden?
No, I made it 15 minutes before we left. I just got in there, chopped it up,
okay.
And
we were off.
I can't believe I made it. Well done. Crazy.
Okay.
But I was going to always make it.
Now, do you want to go next?
Yeah, sure. Okay, I made. I'll do these first because they're sort of easy to remember. So this is like raw peppermint coconut rum kind of thing. So it's just got like cacao butter and raw cacao and agave and coconut and peppermint oil. And it's wrapped up in mint leaves. And these are kale wraps, which are just kind of, I'm just kind of making at the moment. I've just come up with. I've still got a few technical hitches, just in holding them together. So you need to hold them sort of with two hands and just like really get into it.
But you could try chives.
Chives?
Yeah.
Well, I tried to tie them together with garlic chives, but they just don't have a lot of structure.
Oh,
and my garlic chives are really like big and. They're just not very strong. Anyway, they've got carrot and beetroot and zucchini grated up, and they've got capsicum, and then they've got like lots of and the carrots are from the garden, and the lettuce and rocket and herbs. From the garden, and the kale is from a friend's garden.
Wow, lovely.
And they've got a sauce I made, which is made from coriander and mint and lemon and chili and a bit of agave, so it's like a sweet chili kind of thing. And there's like a paste made just from like soaked dolls and tahini, just squished up. So, which didn't look very good, but tastes just
divine.
Yeah.
She's good at that.
Yeah, and I think that's it.
Okay.
Lemongrass, maybe?
Hey? Lemongrass! That would work. Thank you. I've got lemongrass.
Yeah, good one.
Yeah. Cool.
Okay, thanks, Nat. Ben, do you want to go next?
Yep. I made my good old favourite.
Signature dish?
Yes. Yeah, so, you know, just love it. It's carrot, apple, lemon juice, sultanas, desiccated coconut, some cinnamon, some nutmeg, and I've added some cabbage this time. So I love the texture.
Cabbage, okay.
And yes, yeah, crunchy. It's good. And also made this, which is in the recipe. Yeah, it's called porridge. So.
Porridge.
Yeah. It's really thought it'd be good as a dessert sort of thing. I just sort of added a little bit more agave to it to make it sort of sweet. And yeah, it's basically agave, coconut. Coconut cream, apple, a little bit of salt, and then I'll mix some dates and some more apple through it. And I think that's all it is. So, yeah.
Okay, fantastic. Does somebody want to hold the camera? Thank you. Just make sure it's horizontal and not vertical.
No, sure.
Hello, I made this pizza, raw pizza, and the base is buckwheat and cashews with lemon juice and herbs and a little bit of olive oil. And the topping is sun-dried tomatoes with olive oil, lots of garlic, and of course olives and mushroom and more herbs. And it's all dehydrated for about 12 hours altogether. I dehydrated the topping. The tomato topping onto the base. So hopefully you like it. I mean, I've been wanting to make a raw pizza that tastes just like pizza, and this one's pretty good, I think. So thanks very much, and let's enjoy.
Did you put cheese on it?
Ha ha, no.
But we know that cheese you made.
Okay. Hi, Nat. How did you think of the potluck tonight?
It was exquisite, and I think it's a lot, but I just feel really like
happy. Yeah. Yeah, I bet.
When I eat lots of raw food, I almost feel a bit high. I'm just like, I feel vibrant. Whereas when I eat cooked food and see. I feel really heavy,
yeah,
and I have to spend a while just digesting and being a bit tired, and yeah. So raw food.
Yay! Thanks. Okay, Louise, what did you think of the potluck tonight?
Yeah, it was great. It was nice to be a little intimate group, and the food was really delicious. We even had pizza in a real pizza box. Pretty amazing. Yeah, it tasted like real. Normal pizza almost.
Yeah.
Wonderful, yeah. And Leela liked the porridge.
Oh, baby porridge.
Yep, and she liked the cucumber. So, yeah, she enjoyed it too.
Right, thanks very much. Great. Sandy, what did you think of the potluck tonight?
Yum.
Yum, that's very eloquent. Okay, anything else?
Just yum.
All right. Okay, James, what did you think?
Oh, what a delicious feast we had tonight.
Yeah.
Such a variety of amazing foods. It's amazing also all the different people that I eat tonight.
Yeah.
But normally at home I don't eat like this. I eat very simple. I might eat a salad. That's the only thing I would eat next.
Mm.
Normally I eat just like whole fruit as it is.
Yeah.
And then, yeah. So my diet's much simpler than this. My tummy's feeling a little bit funny right now.
Funny.
It's so good. It's just the mixture of things on my body. I'm not used to that.
Mm.
But I can't help myself. It's just such wonderful choices. It's just sweet.
Mm.
and the creativity. I give a 10 tick for creativity.
Yeah, exactly.
The people that don't go for the recipes but just do it themselves and and just willing to try the, you know.
Yeah.
Like, what can I create? Yeah, I've got to start doing that because I haven't been doing that ever, so
okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fun. It's a lot of fun being creative.
Oh, yeah. And presentation.
Yeah.
Is very important.
It's an art form.
Yeah, making it an art.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Okay, then? No? Okay.
Can we do it?
Oh, okay, sure. Whoa, okay.
Sorry, I'll edit that out. Okay, Miki, tell us all about it.
Wait.
I've got to chuck it on there.
Turn it off and then turn it back. It was absolutely superb. Those chocolates, oh my God. There's just like so many dishes that were just like, I mean, you could go into a gourmet restaurant and pay a lot of money and not get anything as good as what we had tonight. And I just wish there were more people enjoying this way of food. Because it's just such a winner, you know. You just can't not like it. And I actually do feel a little bit full at the moment because I ate a bit too much of your chocolate, Matt. I had like three. I couldn't stop myself. But yeah, so I hope everybody will just do their own potlucks wherever they are and spread the word. There's so many online recipes, raw forums and YouTube videos, and you can definitely do it. And it's a lot of fun, and you're helping the planet, your health, the animals. It's great.
And it's easy.
It's easy, absolutely. Thanks, James.